The Liverpool Public Library presents Cellular Data versus Wi-Fi. Cellular data versus Wi-Fi isn't the battle of the century, and it's not even a Supreme Court case. But it is something that's very important for anyone who owns a smartphone to understand. It's about the difference between two ways of getting to the internet from your cell phone when you're away from home. In the wild, so to speak. Let's start off with Wi-Fi. While I'd like to assume that everyone already knows what this is, I'll do a little explaining just to make sure we're all on the same page. Wi-Fi is short for wireless internet, and for the purposes of this video, I'm talking about public Wi-Fi and not what you're already paying for at home. With rare and crazy exceptions, public Wi-Fi is generally free and is provided by businesses as a courtesy, a service, or even as an enticement to get you to do business with them. That's why you'll see it at many libraries, like ours, restaurants, stores and malls, and hotels and motels. Public Wi-Fi is generally free, but isn't available everywhere. If you're in your car, you've got no Wi-Fi access. If you're in the woods, you've got no Wi-Fi access. If you're on a boat, you've got no Wi-Fi access. Cellular data, however, is something different. That's your cell phone using local cell towers, which are everywhere, as a way of getting to the internet. And that works wherever you have cell phone access. In a car, on a plane, on a boat, on a train, even in a box with a fox. But that ability to access the internet anywhere comes at a price. You see, when you use cellular data to access the internet, unless you have what's called an unlimited data plan, you only have a certain amount of data that you're allowed to use each month, and each bit of data you download gets subtracted from that amount. Some things take more data to download than others. Reading email or checking Facebook don't use much data at all, while streaming music or watching a movie will eat you out of house and home. And when you run out of cellular data, some providers will simply cut you off until the next month, while others will charge you a high rate for the additional data. But wait, there's more. One system is faster and more efficient than the other. Wi-Fi can best be described as being like a huge pipe that gives you a lot of water at once. A lot. For free. Cellular data is more like a garden hose that gives you a little bit of water at a time, but charges you for every single drop. So how do you control which one you're using and how much of it you used? Let's start by learning how to tell which is which on your phone screen. Cellular data and Wi-Fi have two different icons to let you know what's being used, or at least what's turned on. The bars on the left show you your cellular signal strength. This is both for phone calls and using cellular data. The radio waves on the right show that Wi-Fi is turned on and its signal strength. If you don't see those radio waves, then Wi-Fi isn't turned on. And frankly, I believe that Wi-Fi should always be turned on. Here's why. Your phone will always try to use the fastest system available to it. And as I've already stated, Wi-Fi is the fastest, so your phone will try that first. If you've got no Wi-Fi symbol, that means you've got no Wi-Fi and are only running on data. And when you're only running on data, you need to be careful about what apps you use. All phones will let you turn cellular data on and off, but some will even let you pick and choose which apps you use it for. My phone is set to not allow YouTube, Netflix, Pandora, Spotify, or any of the app stores to use cellular data. On the other hand, I always want to be able to use Google Maps in case I get lost. There's so much more I could say about this, but this is probably a good place to stop for now. I think I've thrown more than enough data at you.